In this lecture section, we are going to create our first ASP.NET Core Web Application. We're going to create it on Linux, Mac OS X, and Windows. On our Windows device, we will create an application utilizing a project.json in a C# file and compiling it via command line. I'm going to show you how to create it in Visual Studio 2015. On Linux and Mac OS X, I'm going to create it via Visual Studio Code. We're going to utilize Yeoman and an ASP.NET generator to create a scaffolded website. And we're also going to examine the new project structure and components of ASP.NET Core. We're going to examine the project.json, see how all the assembly and DLL files are being compiled in that, and how the NuGet packages restore. We'll also examine the client-side libraries of Gulp and Bower. So we're going to examine just the project structure of ASP.NET Core and take a look at the scaffolding in Visual Studio 2015. We are also going to compare and contrast the legacy framework versus the new structure of ASP.NET Core. We're going to take an ASP.NET 4.6 application, and we're going to compare that to an ASP.NET Core application. And the reason we're going to do that, we're going to look at what contrasts to each other, and then examine the different features of an ASP.NET Core application. With that stated, let's go ahead and get started with creating our first ASP.NET Core web application.